But what happens in the DRI? Well, they're trying to describe the balance in between carbohydrates and fat in dietary intake. And what they say is if you eat too many carbohydrates, you're going to have a decrease in HDL, you're going to have more triglycerides, you're going to have more LDL particles, and ultimately you're going to increase your cardiovascular risk. But they say, in contrast, if you eat a lot of fat, you're going to have more dietary energy, you're going to gain weight, you're going to have more saturated fat, and you're going to have more cardiovascular risk. Okay? That's the argument that's made in the document that shapes what we eat. And essentially, this is the advice that comes down on the Ten Commandments. And what they say is that if you find a balance in between these two different extremes, you can essentially keep your cardiovascular risk to a minimum. So essentially what they're saying is you've got to find a healthy balance in between two extremes of too many carbs or too much fat. So as a friend of mine said, he goes, you mean it's sort of like they're choosing in between black and white, and so they chose 18% gray? I'm like, yes. And what the problem with the AMDR is it had lookup tables in the back, which describe, summarize the 500 pages. And so the AMDR is 500 pages long. No one reads it. They just go to the lookup tables, and they assume that the lookup tables represent all that's contained within. And by the way, the AMDR states explicitly that it does not apply to disease states. And yet it is enforced for disease states like type 1 diabetes around the world.